I've always had a fascination with cars. When I was little, I played with Hot Wheels. And as I got older, I was enthralled in the world of racing video games. Mario Kart, The Crew, Forza Horizon, and, Hot Wheels. Anyway, a big part of a lot of those games is something called drifting. You know that thing where you turn right to go left?
Turn right to go left.
Huh. Yeah, but if you actually do it right, it looks something like this. Oh man, I wish I knew more about the history of drifting.
Special delivery for Kevin Bolger.
Wow, thanks Plankton from SpongeBob. Whoa, box of drifting culture. Let's see what's inside.
What was that?
That is what is known as Eurobeats.
Who are you?
I'm the guy they sent with the box because its contents usually confuse people.
Oh.
Do you want me to explain the history of drifting?
Yes.
Well, it all starts in the early 60s when Japanese professional auto racing began. Around the same time, Kunimatsu Takahashi was the first Japanese motorcycle racer to win a German Grand Prix. That win led him to enter the famously dangerous 1962 Isle of Man 2T, which has 219 turns and had historically killed over 150 riders. Takahashi crashed badly, almost resulting in his death. After a long recovery, he continued his motorcycle racing career windless. And in 1965, Takahashi decided to pursue auto racing, a sport he felt was safer.
Well, just about anything is safer than shut up, I'm talking.
Takahashi set many records throughout his auto racing career, mainly from his fast cornering technique. Tires in 1965 did not have very good grip, which incentivized racers to take it slower on the corners. Conversely, with his nerves of steel he inherited from motorcycle racing, Takahashi would go into turns at a faster speed and aim at the apex, the point closest to the inside of the curve. This causes the back end of the car to swing outward, maintaining the highest speed possible through the turn while aligning the car to be facing the right way after the turn. This technique was and is still referred to as drifting. The other drivers could not match Takahashi's speed in the corners, and he was soon called the father of drifting.
Wait, but that doesn't explain all that crazy music and stuff.
We'll get there when we get there. In the early 70s, a young man named Keiichi Tsuchiya idolized Takahashi and dreamed endlessly of driving fast and racing. Professional auto racing was mainly reserved for the wealthy, so Tsuchiya scraped together all he had and purchased a car. Tsuchiya practiced Takahashi's drifting techniques on mountain roads in his Toyota Corolla AE for over 4 years. The Corolla AE 86 remains one of the most popular drifting cars to this day. Tsuchiya drifted for fun and passion. He said, I drift to overtake, not because it is the quickest way around a corner, but the most exciting way.
Oh! That reminds me of how Okuni from Kabuki Dancer never danced just for fame or fortune, because she was truly passionate about it.
What are you talking about?
Oh, it's nothing. Carry on.
Okay. Whatever. Let's see here. He eventually got involved with unlawful street racing, and his legend grew. His speed was nearly unmatched, especially in the mountain passes, which were called toge, the Japanese word for pass or windy mountain road. Toge racing became popular in the later 70s and involved road racing in the mountains, with races being initiated by a driver flashing their high beams at another, ensuing a race trailed by many. Soicho was called the Drift King and won many of these toge-style races. He began racing professionally in 1977 and had major success.
So, you're saying that he had a sort of, rags-to-riches story?
Well, no, not really. He wasn't that poor.
That sounds like the story of Toyotomi Hideyoshi. You know, the feudal lord of the late Sengoku period? He rose from a peasant background.
Okay, that's a bit of a stretch. And are you trying to impress me or something with these stupid references? There isn't anyone else here, and we're just kind of drifting through space.
Heh, drifting? Like, you know, the...
Okay, where was I? Right, yes. Initial D is a manga series, which follows the story of a delivery boy competing in toad races with his Toyota AE86. Soicha actually contributed to the writing and was also involved when it was made into an anime series, also called Initial D. The anime series featured a genre of music called Eurobeat, which has become synonymous with drifting. That was the music you heard when you first opened the box.
Oh, you want me to open it again?
Okay. No.